I find paper peepshows really exciting. When you're looking through the paper peepshow world, look through the people, you are immersed in this three-dimensional and miniature world that's so different from where we are living in now. Very exciting research discovery that I made was when I visited the Yale Center for British Art. I found a homemade paper peepshow, which looks cannily similar to a homemade work at the Victoria and Albert Museum in London. After I had done a very thorough comparison between the two works, in which I made a small drawings, very simplified drawings for each work to compare the panel by panel, I realized that almost 90% of the figures that you can see on the panels are the same, although the location of them on the panels are different and also the coloring is different. This made me to propose the hypothesis that these two works might be made from the same construction kit for people to make their own paper peepshows at home. And this is very important because if this is true, this might mean that the two works at the Yale and the Victoria and Albert Museum would be the earliest homemade works constructed from a construction kit. This construction kit were probably made for upper and middle classes women. When we have a look at how the figures are cut, we can see that they are executed very nicely and delicately. And that reminds me of the kind of skills that women would need to have when they made their needlework. If we have a look at the bellows connecting the panels, we will see that they are made of cloth instead of paper. This kind of cloth usually be something that middle class and upper class women use in their needlework. I want to explore the world of homemade paper peepshows a lot more in detail because I realized there's much more to it than I had originally thought. I look more closely at the subject matters depicted, looking at how these works were made, and then maybe speculating who made them and for what purposes.